It is an ugly prank, and it really could get someone killed. There is a way that someone can call 911 to report an emergency and make it look like it's coming from your house, even though it's not coming from your house. Next thing you know, there are armed police officers at your home. It's called swatting. Conservative bloggers say it is being used to target them, and some lawmakers are demanding action from the Justice Department. Here's a new part of this. Senator Saxby Chambliss sent Attorney General Eric Holder a letter reading in part. He just did this. The use of swatting as an harassment tool is apparently not new, but its use as a tool for targeting political speech appears to be a more recent development. I am asking you to please look into each of these cases as well as to determine if any federal laws may have been violated here. Erick Erickson is a CNN contributor, and he is a victim of swatting. And we know Eric is conservative, no secret here. All right, let's start. I want to listen to part of the 911 call where someone is claiming to be you, Eric. Listen.
Just shot my wife, so.
You just shot your wife?
I don't think I could come down there.
Where's your wife at now?
Safe for me. She's dead now.
You just shot your wife and she's dead and you don't know where she's located at?
Well, I know where she's located.
Where is she located?
I'm looking at her.
Yeah. What's your phone number, sir?
I don't know. I guess you're gonna have to find out. I'm gonna shoot someone else soon.
It's gotta be chilling to hear that.
You know.
When you think of, about your wife.
Oh, yeah, look, I get targeted all the time for harassment stuff. This is the first time my wife and kids, and when the police officer first drove up into the driveway, he said it was an accidental shooting. Turns out he actually recognized me from CNN.
Hold on. We're going to get to that.
Yeah.
What was going, seriously, when you hear that, what do you think?
It's surreal to hear someone calmly pretending to be me saying they've shot my wife and they're going to shoot someone else again. I mean, calmly saying it, and I mean, very intentionally doing that and pretending to be me. It's surreal.
That upset me, and I'm not even involved. It's terrible. Yeah. After that, what happened? The police show up.
Yeah, the police showed up. It came into the driveway, blue lights flashing. My sister's family's in town. My wife is doing some dishes. We're sitting around chatting. The kids are running outside. My three-year-old is enamored with the police car.
Normal evening.
Yeah, we thought the kids must have done something with the relatives in from town and go out, and the guy hops out. And luckily, he actually had recognized me from being on CNN and was wondering. He comes out and says, accidental shooting. I didn't know until yesterday with the 911 tape that it actually was someone saying shot and killed my wife.
Well, they know who's calling. I mean, but not really, because your address comes up and it says, oh, this is Erick Erickson's house, because they do it some fraudulent way. They get around the system, right?
And yeah, they got around the system. I'm not sure if my address came up or not. He gave it to them for sure.
Okay, all right.
And then a second police officer shows up and comes up the driveway with his hand on his gun as my three-year-old is in the driveway. He keeps his distance behind the trunk of the first police car. Mm-hmm. And come to find out now last night, there were actually police surrounding the house as they were investigating.
When something happens to me, even at work, something weird goes on, you go, oh, I know who's behind this.
Right.
You have your ideas?
You know, I don't know who did this call, but what's interesting is it's happened now three different people in the same voice on the 911 call in all three of these. And they all came. The fact pattern is three of us have written about an individual named Britt Kimberlin, who was a bomber in Indiana in the early 1980s. After we began to write about him, these calls happened.
I have to say, that is not our reporting. And there's no concrete evidence.
Right.
There's been no investigation.
I don't think it's him.
Yeah.
But the fact
pattern
is, I don't think that it's him, and I don't know that
anyone
else does
either. So then why is this has been all over? It's been reported.
Right.
You've seen it on conservative blogs. It's been, there are a number of people out there, I think, even Michelle Malkin. Am I wrong?
And the fact pattern is, it all came about after writing about this individual. Someone who, I guess, likes him decided to do it, which is a real problem, that he's apparently got a fan club out there of some odd individuals. But all three of us, within weeks of writing about the individual, this happens. It's the same voice on all the 911 calls.
And again, I have to reiterate, that's what's out there in the blogosphere and being reported by some people that has not been corroborated.
Right.
Do you think it's a bit premature to start claiming that it's some sort of liberal plot against conservatives?
I don't think so, in that these are the three public ones, but there's other incidents following similar fact patterns, and the latest is an individual also writing about the same topic, having his mother's home address and pictures put up online.
The new thing about this, because you said it's been happening before, it's happened before, but having police officers and sometimes SWAT teams show up at your house, that's got to be chilling. you must be relieved. This is a new pig that Senator Saxby Chambliss of Texas wants an investigation. Of Georgia, sorry. And then Texas Congressman Kenny Marchant. They're calling for an investigation in this. Are you glad about that?
I am, because the individual who had it happen in New Jersey and the other in Los Angeles, their police have met dead ends because it's clearly someone doing it over a voice over IP system. So the local police don't have the resources to track it. With it being the same voice in three cases, you've got to imagine there's some interstate issues involved.
Okay, I want to ask you this. And I'm being serious here, not because, you know, we can't always right. be partisan, and some people call it political hacks, right?
Right.
When something like this happens, is this a call for people to understand that politics can sometimes, depending on the rhetoric and civility, can be life or death situations when it shouldn't be? Just because I disagree with you politically right. does not mean that I should call police. People take this stuff seriously. Should we tone down the rhetoric? Should we become more civil? Should there be more civility? And should we realize, hey, listen, it's just politics. At the end of the day, nobody died. Stop it.
Yes and no. Political rhetoric's always going to be heated. It was much more heated in the 1800s than it is today.
There's a difference between heated political rhetoric
exactly.
and putting someone's life on the line.
You know, Eric. This happens in third world kleptocracies and banana republics.
Right.
This is the United States. It shouldn't happen here.
We should be a bit more careful.
Come on,
Eric. Don't you think?
Yeah, I mean,
I'm not just, I'm talking about liberals and conservatives, and we should realize most people are somewhere in the middle. You're very conservative, don't you agree?
Right.
Yeah, and there are people who are on the left who are very liberal. Mm-hmm. Most Americans are somewhere in the middle, and they don't care about the extremes.
You know, it's not an issue of where you are on the political spectrum. It's an issue of the other guy, you may disagree with them, but you mm-hmm. shouldn't be trying to summon a SWAT team to their house.
And something like this, if somebody's doing it, it's just that they've got some serious issues yes. that goes beyond politics.
Very much so. You can hear it. Just in the tone of voice with the 911 call, there's someone with some issues.
We're glad you're okay. Sorry about your kids. I can't imagine when you're a kid, you think, oh, flashing lights, this is all great.
Yeah.
Then when you're an adult, the last thing you want to see at your house is a police officer, unless someone there's
you
an
very
intruder.
Very much so.
Right? Thank you, Eric.
Thank you.
Good.